This week on Rochelle's Daily Wire Video Edition, we have an update on City of Chicago versus Fulton, that important automatic stay decision from January that was handed down unanimously by the Supreme Court. As Yogi Berra was reported to have said, "It ain't over till it's over," and that could not be a more apt summary of the status of the Fulton case. The Fulton case was actually four cases that came up from the Seventh Circuit. The City of Chicago is very aggressive about collecting parking tickets and fines. If you don't pay your parking tickets and fines, they impound your car. Well, people in Chicago started filing Chapter 13 petitions. They would go to the impound and say, "Okay, give me back my car." The City of Chicago refused. But in four different cases, four different Chicago bankruptcy judges held that that is an automatic stay violation under Section 362C3. The case was appealed directly to the Seventh Circuit, and the Seventh Circuit agreed, yes, that is an automatic stay violation. There was a split of circuits, so the Supreme Court granted certiorari, but reversed in January, and said that merely maintaining the status quo is not an act, and therefore is not an automatic stay violation. The Supreme Court, of course, remanded to the Seventh Circuit. The City of Chicago, on remand in the Seventh Circuit, said, "Listen, this is very simple. Just vacate the judgments in all four of the cases." But that's not what the Seventh Circuit said. The Seventh Circuit pointed out that the decision from the Supreme Court only dealt with Section 362C3. At least two of the cases in the Seventh Circuit also involved subsections C4 and C6. One of those says that it's a stay violation if you control property of the estate, and another says it is a stay violation if you attempt to collect a debt that is subject to the automatic stay. In short, the Seventh Circuit said, "Look, we don't have any ruling from the Supreme Court on A4 or A6, and therefore the Seventh Circuit remanded the cases to the bankruptcy courts for decisions on C4 and C6. Well, I'm going to go out on a limb, and I'm going to guess that at least some of the bankruptcy judges in Chicago say that, yes, it is a violation of C4 or C6. It's going to go on direct appeal again to the Seventh Circuit after a finding of a stay violation. And I am pretty sure the City of Chicago will seek a certiorari petition once again. This time around, I'm not so sure that the Supreme Court is going to grant cert, because I don't believe we're going to have a circuit split. And also, on C4 and C6, it's not such a monumental case as it was for the Supreme Court to have decided, as they did in Fulton, that you have to have some real act, and that simply holding the status quo is not a stay violation." I am Bill Rochelle, Editor-at-Large for American Bankruptcy Institute. I will return same time next week with a report on something interesting from the world of bankruptcy. Until then, be well. Good day.